Okay, in this movie, I just want to talk about doing some animation and the most basic stuff here. So there's obviously much more complex things you can do with Maya, but let's just look at moving an object and how to set those keyframes. You'll notice that I've set the little animation pop-up here, so we get some menus for animation. And I also went over to the animation tab. And there's some interesting things you can experiment with. There's bones in Maya, referred to as joints, but you can work with them. If you remember fiddling around with Flash at all, there was bones in Flash too, but it was two-dimensional, so 3D adds another set with that. But I'm going to leave that for another day. Right now, I just want to kind of show you down at the bottom this pretty elementary set of frames where when you make a new project in Maya, it shows you 1 second, it's 24 frames. Notice that it goes out 48 frames. So down along the bottom here, I can slide this and it shows the full 48. If I want to make an animation that goes further, I could do that too just by typing in a new amount. So if I type in 60, notice that it now traverses for the whole 60 frames. A couple of other things. I'm on frame one here. That's the black dot that you see. Nothing selected. So right now, if I try to set keyframes, it's not really going to affect anything. I also have auto keyframe turned on. So that means that once I start fiddling with a shape and I set an initial keyframe, then it's going to modify that keyframe every time I or modify automatically for me. It'll set keys for me if I move to another frame and move the shape. So I'm going to turn that off just because that's probably what you see to begin with. And let's just move this model. So it starts off on frame one. And the first thing I'm going to do, I want to click on the shape that I'm going to animate. And I'm going to just press S. And when I do that, I don't know if you can see down here, but there's now a little red line indicating that a keyframe has been set. So if I move this out to frame 10, for example, and then move the object up, and then set another keyframe, pressing S, I now have a little bit of animation between the two. And notice that it redraws the current active window. So you can see it in the front view, and then when you stop, perspective view updates. If I click in perspective view and drag, you'll notice it goes up and down. Now I deselected my object, so I need to go back and select that. And another thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to change its orientation point because I want its pivot point to be down at its base because I'm going to have it smush against the ground. So to do that, I'm just back at frame one and I'm going to press the home key. And doing so allows me to move the pivot point. I'm going to just drag the pivot point down and over this window here, let's zoom in nice and close so I can kind of see that pivot point a little better. Okay, so now my pivot point's right at the bottom of the shape. Press home again, and it just goes back to where it was. So nothing much has changed here. It's just I repositioned home. So now when I bring it back down here to, let's say, frame 18, drag this down, set my keyframe. All right, now it's moving up and then down. I'm going to go one keyframe before that and just set another one because I'm going to have it impact the surface as it hits the floor. So right before that, I'm just going to set another keyframe, extend that to where it's hitting the ground, and now we'll just switch over to the scale tool. And I'm going to squash the shape down a bit and stretch it out. And again, if you want to use the channel box for this is a good way to work because you can see the scale settings here. So I might come in and set my scale a little more severely, 1.3, whoops, 1.3. Cool. So now it makes that squash. And here it is with the original scaling. So it comes down, squashes. Oh, you know what? I think I forgot to set my squash. That's what I forgot to do there. So I need to come in. Let's bring that down again. Sorry. It's one nice thing about auto keying. Press S. That updates the keyframe. Let's pop back. Here we go. Good. So if we look at this motion, squash. Okay. And then we could continue this. I could go ahead and have it bounce back up. We might have it go over to a couple further frames out, frame 25. Have it move up. And here I'm gonna reset it so it's back to one scale. Set the keyframe. And you know what? I think I forgot to set the keyframe. So you can see here, I'm gonna turn on auto key modify because I'm obviously messing up while I'm going. So let's move it up here and just set it. And there is a little red line there, so it should now have that keyframe, and sure enough, as it goes back up, it slows down and it re-establishes. Okay, so now it's back to its original scale. And we could continue this. Let me just bring it down one more time. We'll just have this come down at frame 31. Let it set that keyframe. I'm gonna go back one. So the reason I go back and then set the keyframe is that now I know where it is in space. I don't have to guess. I set the keyframe at the end of the run and then I just move back one to find out where that is. So again, now I'm gonna scale this guy down. Now that the previous keyframe's been set, and we'll just scale it out a bit. Let's do 2. Always trying to preserve volume. So if it squishes vertically, it needs to extend horizontally. There it goes. And then let's just have it bounce back up. At this point, I'm gonna just reset its scale. So we'll just set this at 1. And if I wanted to have a jiggle there right at the end, I guess I could do that too. So I could do 1.1. There's a little bit of a jiggle. And then frame 35, we'll just set it back to 1. All right, so now if I scrub through this, I'm going to expand this to expand it so I can see more frames. I'm going to click and drag on one of the squares along the bottom edge here. I can now see the frames of the animation. And I can scrub through and you can see it hits and then hits again. I should make this just a little bit bigger. There we go, get some impact and a little bit of wobbliness there. So it looks kind of like it's made out of rubber, which is convenient since it's a little rubber duck planted on there too. Okay, so we have kind of a little initial animation. Now this is animating just the entire object. Now you can also do component level animation. So if I wanted to adjust some of these guys, just some of the tips, for example, I might come back, right-click on this, and choose vertex, and select just the vertices. Let's zoom in Let me see if I can get just the tops. Top points. So I'm gonna select these guys. There. So now I have just the little vertices. And I'm gonna do something similar. I'm gonna go ahead and set a keyframe for those guys. So I'm just now working with just a component of the overall object. And if I wanted to, I suppose I could, we could take a look at these top vertices too. Let's try that out. So I'm gonna select these guys and there we go. All right, so I now have a number of these components selected. And we're gonna just do a little bit of secondary animation with them. Not that much, but just a little bit. So first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and press S to set keyframes for these guys. And you'll notice that that shows up. Even though they're part of the larger object, they now have a separate set of keyframes. Now, as this takes off, you know, they move up with the rest of the object. Wonder if I got all of them here. You know, I think I missed one. That little guy, well, might just be, we'll see. So as it moves up, I'm gonna have it come up, and maybe there's gonna be just a little delay. So as it starts off, I'll have these guys move down a bit. There we go. So it starts off and they move down, gets up to the top, and then as it gets around the top, let's extend it the other way. So now they're kind of exaggerating and coming the other direction, so it looks a little more rubbery. Comes down and squashes. Next frame, why don't we again compress this? And I should probably, let's undo it. Let's have it be a couple frames out. There we go. And then now it pops back up. As it rounds the top and starts to fall, we'll move it up again. Have it come down. And squish a little bit after. There, so now it wiggles up. Then it goes, let's have it go down. So I'm just kind of having it bobble based off of what we're seeing there before. And maybe the last little bit, have it readjust. Let's check out what it's doing here. So maybe just have it come down a little bit and then up. So again, components are kind of cool because you can animate a part of an object in addition to the whole object. So you can get a really bubbly looking thing. So this thing's now bouncing around, and I've done some primary stuff and I've done some secondary stuff to make this look a little more rubbery, a little elastic as I'm doing these deformations. Okay, so that's very rudimentary animation, but you can kind of see here the idea of setting keyframes. Again, your keyframes are going to show up as little red lines that you have to press S to set them initially for whatever you're working on. One thing that you want to get in the habit of doing is when you start working with the timeline, make sure that you're starting at frame one for stuff, unless you want things to start and just kind of progress up to the frame you're at, and then you're setting a keyframe there. Just get in the habit of getting to frame one. The little auto key symbols over in the lower right, and you can see the effect of also working in these different views. Sometimes the perspective view isn't going to be the best view for getting this thing done. Okay, I hope this makes sense.